All right, it's time. This is going to be Dan Kruger Battlegrounds number 37. So far, yeah, 7 out of 8 people checked in. We've got a pretty good bracket today. There we go, tournament started. So first up, it's going to be Mitch Testy versus Mestre Ryu. Thank you for joining us this tournament all the way from Brazil. So I think, again, I'll stream all of winners and losers round 1 and 2 can be off stream. And as always, guys, remember if you're worried about the connection, maybe turn up your delay by one or two frames. I'd say like, two or three is probably good. Yeah, it's okay. I have time. But yeah, other upcoming matches will be Max Out versus Scuddy and Mebeador versus Moomaster. This has been a while since Moomaster has entered the tournament too. That's going to be exciting. Moomaster is a very good Liza player. Yeah, if you guys want to test the connection, I mean, you can just start the match, see how it feels, and if you're playing the match and it doesn't feel good, then we can call a test and see who has like a stable connection. I do have the website. Let me pull that up. If people need the packet loss test, that is here. Also put that in the tournament chat. On Discord, if anyone needs it.
Round one. Fight.
All right. I've been thinking a lot more about like how to tackle Kazuya as a character because a few more people now are playing him. I mean, yeah, Mitch, I didn't know who Mitch played in this game, so that's nice. But I know yesterday I played Lord Genzo from Mexico, and obviously Golden Shades have been giving me a lot of trouble with this character. I think Lee was best option for dealing with this. I mean, 2HK low profiles, but you kind of have to be really close for it to hit. So you kind of run the risk of him doing like a, crouching MK or something and getting a combo off that. Nice DP. Yeah, that DP is her other answer. It's very reliable, pretty long range. Because Lihua's problem is her normals are a little short range, but her DP is generously invincible. It's actually a Tiger Knee motion, so it's a bit easier to do, I feel like, walking up. And like out of a crouch, especially, that helps sometimes. A bit of jumping around. Jumping around's not bad versus Kazuya, just because it's a little tricky to actually hit someone out of the air with DP, because the hitbox, when he reaches the height, doesn't really cover his legs. It's like he's a little vulnerable above, so if you're jumping very high, then you might hit him out of it. Oh, good backdash. Yeah, you gotta watch your toes. Let's see how this match goes. Oh, nice. Yeah, I've been thinking a lot about the round start backdash too, because for Kazuya, and I mean, I play Bartz, and in that matchup, it's really strong for Kazuya because I have to make a hard read and like throw Sonic Boom in order to stop him from just backdashing and starting up the fireball trap. Oh, wow. Okay, Mr. Ryu really dominating this match right now. Oh, nice. Yeah, you can see the range on that DP. Oh, nice reversal. Ooh. Not entirely sure what happened there.
Round two. Fight.
As Kazuya, thankfully, there you go, that's much better. Thankfully, as Kazuya, you have easily the best dive kick in the game, maybe like second to Gonzalez, but you have the fastest dive kick and it travels at a pretty good angle, so you can use that on knockdown to score a cross up.
Nice.
Oh, dang. I don't think he knows, but you do have to use Kazuya 2 and 4P to punish Lihua's DP on block. Okay, this is a tricky situation. Ah, takes it with a crouching light kick. And that's going to be 2-0 for Mr. Ryu. Nice. Okay, next up, Maxed Out versus Scuddy. I'm trying to remember. This might also be Liza versus Lihua. Yeah, I think for me, what pushes Kazuya over the edge is just how little recovery his fireball has. Because a lot of the stuff that seems like, him having Grand Viper seems really absurd on its face, but the fact that most characters can punish that really solidly helps. Bards, for example, especially at round start, he does Light Thunder Knuckle, and if you have the wall, you can combo that into stun. Because you only get the first hit, which just launches on its own. But it's about thinking of it in terms of 50-50. Like, he can do backdash and you can beat that with fireball. Or you can, like, walk forward and position yourself so that if he tries throwing a fireball, you can do standing medium kick. Anyway, Liza's a very funny character who just does an absurd amount of damage if she hits you with some stuff, like that spin kick. She also has... there's really good fireballs, and both the monkey and the bird are just act as like high and low tiger shot, or I guess you could compare them to Remy's fireballs in Third Strike. Oh, okay, drops a combo. Yeah, I think heavy kick version of monkey will actually beat Psycho Crusher. Otherwise, that would have been a good answer there. Okay, very quickly, game one going to Maxed Out. Ooh, possible character switch? Okay. Yeah, Gecko is Scuddy's secondary. Gecko is also very good. I think... I don't know about this matchup, though. I think he still gets hit twice by spins, so that, you know, if he tries to play a little too risky, he gets blown up for it. I think in general, he needs to find a position where he can, like, reactively jump over fireballs and then double jump back if he tries to do something else. But yeah, he's kind of fragile and lacks a reversal outside of either throws or backdash. Alright, walking up. Yeah, you kind of have to watch out for Bird too, but you can double jump over it with Gecko. Oh, yeah, standing heavy kick from Gecko, not a fantastic button. Oh. That actually could have been it if they'd combo into Tatsu. Okay, nice, gets a knockdown. The problem is this is kind of scary to try to go for on Liza, because she has mash move. So she doesn't really care too much what side you end up on. Ooh, yeah. And then trying to play projectile war just kind of doesn't work out with her. Again, maybe Bartz can do it, because her fireball and Bartz are kind of matched in terms of startup. But for Gecko, yeah, it's a lot of, like, double jumping around, sometimes doing, like, neutral jump, medium kick or heavy kick, just to, like, potentially catch Psycho Crusher. Because if you if you neutral jump and do Tatsu, Air Tatsu will go forward. Like, the nature of this game is that your jumps are always kind of a mix-up, especially if they want to, like, block your jump-ins to be safe instead of trying to anti-air you, in which case you get a double jump to mix that up. But Gecko really kicks it up to 11 because he has Tatsu, which has pretty low landing recovery, so if he does decide to delay it, do it low to the ground, that's hard to react to. And you can just do double jump whenever instead of as a cancel. Okay, next up we'll have Mibedor versus Moomaster. Okay, I see Moomaster's available.
Round one. Fight! Round two. Fight.
Oh, okay. My bad, guys. So, yeah, OG Cornflakes, really solid player all around. He's been playing a lot more Cyberbots, but I think in this game, yeah, he knows how to play patiently with Gecko. He knows where his best buttons are, and especially just like, yeah, he's very good with these anti-airs. And that matters a lot. That's where a lot of his character's damage comes from, is just winning air interactions. Obviously, if he air-to-airs you and combos into Tatsu, usually you're getting stunned. But even controlling the ground, he does pretty well. Yeah, see, there was a bit of delay there, but if he had done that lower, or if he had acted as soon as he landed, then a lot of people would get caught by that. And he also, you know, has throw as a mix-up. Alright, so he switches to Liza, and I feel like this matchup is pretty good for Liza. It's just about kind of, yeah, finding the time to set up like fireball traps or to sneak in a Psycho Crusher. Although Gecko doesn't have much trouble actually stopping Psycho Crusher, yeah, he has, again, he has fireball, he has really good standing buttons, like he has jab, standing heavy punch works well. Or especially standing medium kick, honestly one of the better standing buttons in the game. Okay, this might be running down to time. Yeah, Gecko's ability to run away is also really strong in some situations. I think because he's so fragile, it's kind of difficult to get enough of a lead. But if you're in that position, it's hard for most characters to catch up to him. Nice, I like the idea there. I think if she had done Psycho Crusher, that would have caught. Nice. Ooh, alright. I like the whiff Psycho Crusher into sweep. I think it's cool because Liza's sweep is pretty much safe. It's zero on block. Like, maybe in theory some characters can guard cancel punish it, but that's pretty difficult. Right. Very close match, but it goes to OG Cornflakes. Right, because the thing about guard cancel is that makes the move effectively like it's minus 7, but only to specials. So, I'm actually not sure if Gecko could punish that, because Tatsu does not move that fast on the ground. If she does it at point blank, though, he could Desperation, which is a command grab with pretty good range. Alright, I haven't got a response from Ibid, or it's been about 10 minutes. I'm going to count that. We'll see if Scuddy, if Mevedor shows up, play him. If not, whatever. And we're going to get maxed out versus Moomaster. Okay, let's see this matchup. Moomaster has a bunch of random characters he plays, which he's all good with them. Yeah, Jay McCoy, one of them. I was thinking Liza, Jay McCoy, Boggy. Who knows who else he plays? I want to say maybe Marco, just to complete all the kind of weird, later half of the character select. And yeah, definitely Gonzalez. Forgot about Gonzalez somehow. All right. This is off to a decent start for maxed out. Thing is, McCoy does have some pretty damaging mix-ups. It's just, he has kind of trouble with zoning, especially with like low projectiles where he can't, slide or use Jet Upper to get under them. Oh, throw punish, okay. Oh, the overhead. Only one hit though. I think if he got both hits, that might have killed. Ooh.
Round two. Fight.
Yeah, I think Mib is out. I don't blame him though. Hopefully he's around for my stream tomorrow, which I was planning on doing a stream to go over like old game balance, because I think people overrate how imbalanced a lot of old games are. Even some of the weirder stuff, like, you know, TMNT Tournament Fighters, or, I don't know, Breaker's Revenge. Alright, nice. Yeah, Moomaster, oh, that was kind of sick. Moomaster is known for taking these big risks that pay off. Ooh, nice slide. The slide you always 100% have to watch out for. It's such a huge asset for McCoy to have. And it really suits his kit as a charge character. And I think, I'm pretty sure it will outright beat Liza's spin, but it loses its Psycho Crusher, yeah, exactly. So I think in general you're gonna have to use that Psycho Crusher often, but... he does have ways to stuff it. And even if he trades with the straight punch, that's still a very favorable knockdown for him. Yeah, that move right there, that move is really helpful for him. Very long reaching poke. Oh, nice. Good slide. Yeah, so a lot of playing around McCoy is kind of assuming he's going to slide when he's in the range to do so. It's not an instant low profile, so you can hit him with some like standing pokes or some special moves before he actually goes low. Oh, good throw. Alright, with some mix-up. Yeah, those are a little mistimed. Oh. Oh, that was a weird cross-up. Okay. Yeah, right now this is looking very good for maxed out. Yeah, in general, I think when you're at that range, you want to just block low against McCoy when you're, like, just a couple steps away from him. Even if the threat of overhead is there, you know, you can... sometimes it's good to just mash preemptively to stop the overhead. Oh. Alright, decent punish. I think he could have backdashed from that. I think for Liza, the best thing you can do is just standing heavy kick. That's her longest reaching button. Punishing with her is kind of weird if you can't hold down charge for Psycho Crusher, which you can't against that Thunderbolt. It's an overhead. Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the other thing. Overhead does whiff if it's too close. But it kind of serves well to space it anyway, just so you can't get thrown. Oh, I wonder if Liza would have been able to kill if she comboed into Psycho Crusher from those jabs. Oh, gets hit by the full super. That almost killed. Yeah, there's a slide, of course. I wonder if, like, the best answer to taking slide on Oki, you know, if is to, like, try and fuzzy jump that, you know, hold down back to block the slide and then jump out to avoid the overhead. He probably has counters to that, but I think jumping out is a pretty good option for Liza. Oh. Yeah, that was almost really bad. Alright. So this is an even match right now. Mu has super, which means he's probably going to use it sometime soon. Yep, there it is. Oh, I think Psycho Crusher would have... Oh, okay, good. Throw Punish, taking it for maxed out. They're 1-1 right now. Oh, okay, there's a Gonzalez switch. I think maybe this will help him slow things down, and especially, you know, end things quicker if he finds punish opportunities with command grab. But it's kind of tricky to navigate Liza's projectiles and, you know, catch up to her after Psycho Crusher. But yeah, if Gonzalez lands a command grab now, it won't kill, but it'll create such a life lead for him. Oh, okay, this is dead. Yeah. He could have rolled on wake up, but that's very hard to do. You have to press all three kicks at the same time. Oh, is the Discord command broken? Hold on. There we go. Also, hi Heather. So, if you're watching this stream, you get to be, like, frustrated with people doing unsafe plays. Oh, nice cross-up.
Round three. Fight.
Alright. And the good thing about that sweep is it's plus 4 on block. For some reason. Oh, empty jump throw? That's gonna be huge. Nice. Hitting with a low. I've never actually seen Gonzalez standing or close standing heavy kick used like that. Aha, nice command grab. That was a really close set. Moomaster taking it 2-1. I think empty jump grab and especially command grab is really good in this game. Because, again, there's so many small mix-ups in your jump because everyone has a dive kick and really good jump buttons. It's very easy to condition someone to just kind of chill out and wait for your jump in and just snatch them like that. Yeah, Mebedor said he was working and he'll be home in 20 minutes, so at that point, either way, I would have had to DQ, unfortunately. Alright. I think... Oh, no. Mitch Jesse has been on stream before. Okay. I thought maybe for a second Mitch hadn't been on stream, so I was going to give him a match, but I'm going to follow through with streaming winners. We're going to get OG Cornflakes versus Moomaster on winners finals, 1-3. And then in losers round 2, you guys can all play off stream. So that's Maxed Out versus Mitch. And Mr. Ryu versus Scotty. Okay, here we go. I feel like whatever we get here is going to be a good matchup. Ooh, okay, there's a Boggy. So we've seen three different characters so far from Moon Master. We're probably going to see four by the end of this bracket. I don't know how to feel about this matchup. I think just... Oh, here it goes. All right, yeah, opt for the guaranteed knockdown. Thing about this character is if you're more confident in your Oki, you can just go for the knockdown straight up. But yeah, I feel like Gecko just kind of locks in the neutral. Like his grounded game is a bit stronger than Boggy's. I guess the difference is like Boggy does more damage, but... Alright, sorry. Boggy does slightly more damage, but it's kind of hard for him to open you up properly. Like, he doesn't have an overhead, his jump is kind of slow. He doesn't have too reliable, like, combo enders from a distance. And again, his walk speed is really slow, so he kind of has to make big reads in order to score a knockdown. But his set play is pretty strong if he does manage to do that. And he does have, like, a long-range sweep. He has wheel spin, 2147k, which is really long-reaching. And we'll go over lows. Oh, good sweep. You can also cancel his sweep, which is kind of interesting. He doesn't have anything like... He doesn't really use fireball for it, just because most characters can crouch his fireball, but... Oh, nice. Yeah, it is a good anti-air, though. There's that. Ooh. Good double jump from OG Cornflakes. Alright. Okay, no full combo. And opting to jump out, yeah. Because Boggy's reversal upkick is 2-8k, it doesn't care about what side you're on, so it's pretty reliable if he's trying to do cross-ups and stuff. Very nice. And yeah, Gekko's walk speed is so absurdly fast that he can just kind of hit something on block and just walk back for a frame trap. Oh, the... Moon Master was definitely trying to do Boggy's desperation there, which is a command grab and the input is like half circle back and then back to down. It's a really awkward input. It's easy to overshoot it and put out a fireball. Hold on. Yeah, okay, proper sides. Alright, Moon Master switching to Wulong. Okay. This wasn't one of his characters that I named. Wulong's pretty good. I feel like he kind of struggles with neutral because his pokes aren't great, but he has a really good slide that, unlike Jay McCoy's that I was mentioning before, Wulong's slide is actually low profile on frame one. So just having that factor is very helpful for him. He has a good DP as well. But otherwise, his buttons are kind of weak in terms of range and disjoint. He does have a very long range sweep as well, which he can cancel, so that's a nice benefit. Alright, maxed out, study 120, cool. We'll see, maybe this is the ticket that Moon needs to bring things back. Yeah, because there are a lot of frame traps, like into fireball like that, which a lot of characters will be forced to block, but Wulong can simply slide under. Alright, good throw from OG Cornflakes. Ooh, alright. Oh yeah, oh no, he doesn't block. Yeah, there's Wulong Super. It's a very good move. Hits low. It's actually plus on block, but he pushes too far to make that really broken. But it's plus on block. It does a good chunk of chip, and it hits low, so you always have to watch out for that. Man, just spamming that DP. Nice. Okay, I like the choice to cancel sweep into DP there. Actually, I don't think it really does anything for him, but I guess it does kind of distract if you expect a fireball and maybe try to tattoo over it. Nice. I like using the dive kick to get closer like that. Oh, and the trade.
Round two. Fight.
Yeah, all the chip damage that Wulong scores is important in this matchup. Oh, nice. Really good DP. Oh, dang, that's probably not what OG Cornflakes wanted to do. Right? Yep, abusing those plus frames. Oh, nice, good catch. Man, that's rough. Neutral jumping is usually pretty good in this game, though. I think that at that point, jump medium kick could have stopped Wulong. Nice. God, that is so much chip damage right there. Okay, nice. Oh, I was expecting maybe like a TK Tatsu. Because from there that would have crossed up. That's what makes Gekko so powerful in my opinion, is just his ability to instantly mix you. It doesn't do too much damage unless you're landing like a big jump in, but being able to suddenly mix someone up and, you know, you get free chip with his projectile is pretty useful. Yeah, I fixed it on the challenge bracket. It says 2-1, I think, right now. Okay, nice. Yeah, all DPs in this game do lose their invincibility pretty quick. And the hitboxes later are actually kind of bad, so they'll usually lose to jump-ins. Oh no. Oh, that hurts. Alright. Moomaster taking it 3-1. Okay, this is gonna be losers round 3. This is losers semifinal, so still first to 2. We'll be on stream. Hmm. Yeah, if cornered, jump forward Tatsu usually does it. You also might have just been too late there. That also happens. But I think jump light kick and jump medium kick, if that was a neutral jump, they're the same. If that was a back jump, then obviously you can see how good of a button diagonal jump MK is. Yeah, when you were landing on chicken wing there, was that neutral jump or was that back jump? Either way, I think the faster button would have helped. Oh yeah, okay, yeah, Tatsu would have worked. Okay, so pretty expected character selections here. Ooh. Okay, good picking up a combo off that, yeah. Even point blank, the projectiles have a lot of advantage, so if you hit someone with that, you can walk up and combo off it. Oh, nice throw. Yeah, I think in general you have to be pretty careful with Oki on Liza, but Lihua luckily has sword. You know, 412 HP is really good. Not a great trade. Okay, good sweep. Oh. I did not expect that DP to go in reverse. All right. Yeah, the thing about Lihua is her mix-ups in the air aren't as good. Her dive kick's a little slow, but it's got a good hitbox at least. But she also lacks any air specials, and her buttons are kind of short, so if she does like a neutral or back jump cancel, it's hard for her to really do anything with that. I think she really just plays a solid grounded game. And if she can, you know, approach slowly and land a solid hit or poke something out with DP, then that's where she sees the most success because she gets a lot of free chip off any knockdown. Oh, that was weird. But yeah, you can see how fast Liza's damage stacks up. Oh yeah, I guess Lihua sweep will also outright beat spin, so that's helpful. Oh, nice. Good anti-air. But yeah, I'd pretty much always stick to the heavy version of that move. The lighter medium is, I mean, I guess it does have more active frames, so it can be used as an anti-air on a read. And it's a bit safer to whiff than DP. But other than against Gonzalez specifically to like beat his rolls, because there's a chance that he'll like roll straight through 412 HP, and that's no good. Other than that, I wouldn't recommend it. Guess the good thing is in this matchup, Liza also doesn't have particularly long range buttons, so it's worth throwing that out. Oh no. Yeah, this is dead. Oh, mistimed that a little bit. I think for punishing that move on block, Lihua has to do 412 HP. She can technically 214 6P, but the first hit will actually whiff, so you have to be very tight on the timing. Oh, ouch. Alright, that's 2-0, my bad. Once again, thank you for playing Maestri Ryu. It was nice having you. I hope you enjoy a new comeback next tournament. Next up is going to be Losers Finals, OG Cornflakes versus Maxed Out. And then the winner of this will have to play Mu Master in Grand Finals. It's going to be interesting because I know Mu has already played so many characters and he'll have a lot of space to mess around with other characters. Alright. Yeah, I think this matchup, you have to change out how you approach versus a lot of characters. Just because being reckless around Liza means that you'll eat a spin and probably die. But otherwise, again, Gekko kind of outbuttons her. It's just a matter of navigating projectiles, which he does pretty well compared to a lot of characters. I mean, you can see right there, 6 HK sails clean over Monkey, which is really helpful. Nice. Yeah, I like to jump back. I wonder if like doing an instant, like a quick jump back into jump forward to set up a cross-up might be more helpful, just because if you know the spin is coming anyway, you might as well put them into a real mix-up. Oh, nice anti-air. Is it going to be enough though? Oh, damn. I think if Max had hit 2 MP there, that might have done it. Nice. Oh, okay, this is getting awkward. But yeah, whenever you block Liza's Psycho Crusher, she does go full screen, so you can't punish it objectively unless she's in the corner. But a lot of characters can, you know, throw a projectile or use a special move to close in. And that will at least prevent her from like doing another Psycho Crusher or sometimes a projectile, depending on which one. Alright, nice. Good frame traps. The good thing about Gekko is he has a lot of disjointed buttons that recover really fast, like crouching MP is a really good one. Also, even crouching HP is a bit disjointed. Oh, that was interesting use of Liza's dive kick. I think her dive kick is definitely the worst one, but that's because it kind of doesn't function as a dive kick at all. She just kind of flips above the screen, and it's used for movement more than it is for hitting anyone. Right, nice. I feel like it's, in a lot of situations, it's hard to confirm that Tatsu, you just, unless they do something, like they jump into it in a very obvious way, like there. Yeah, good using double jump to stall over projectiles. Ooh, okay. Okay, this is neck and neck right now. Oh no. Alright. Aw, man. Yeah. Tatsu as a runaway tool is so valuable. Oh, nice. Yeah, in general, I think the worst thing Gekko can do is stand still. Just reminding people that you have all these different options to approach, like the low Tatsu, like the double jump. Oh, yeah, this is it. Man. Alright. This is still... Oh, sorry, I forgot to report the first match. Yeah, this is still 1-0 because of those timeouts. Thankfully, timeouts are also somewhat fast. The timer in this game's fast. But you should definitely get into the mindset of sometimes it's best for you to just hold back and wait and not force yourself to interact with like the inherent 50-50s of dive kicks and stuff like that. Oh, that was a really late hitting bird. Nice. Not an ideal punish though. It would have been good to sweep him for that. Oh, nice close heavy kick. Oh, wow. I wonder if that jab crossed up. I'm thinking OG Cornflakes just got hit out of his button first, but that jump LP is really weird. Alright, both players taking a moment to chill. Alright, playing neutral right now. Yeah, you can't get overzealous with your pressure as Gecko and get hit by a spin kick like that. Nice, good shimmy. Gecko's in kind of a weird spot with whiff punishing because his most prominent options are just, crouching heavy punch or crouching medium punch if it's like a really quick situation. He doesn't have a way to like confirm into knockdown like most characters, and his sweep is not amazing. It's a little slow and doesn't have too much range. So like getting a knockdown off a whiff punish is not common for him. Oh, all right, this is tricky. Oh yeah, good cyber crusher. It's usually worthwhile to throw that out. It's like a bit faster than, your typical Psycho Crusher. It's like, I think 4 or 6 frame startup for light and heavy. Right, good anti-air. Certainly hits it just too high of an angle for Gecko to get jump MP off of. Nice. Okay, I like the idea. Oh, nice desperation move there. Oh my god, that killed? Wow. Okay, well played from OG Cornflakes. That move is terrifying. Okay, this could be the game. Oh, nope. Alright, knockdown still. Okay. Max out gets the throw instead of OG Cornflakes. Oh, yeah, that's gonna chip out. Yeah, it can all happen so fast. Alright, this is 2-1 for OG Cornflakes. Still, it's really easy for Elias to suddenly steal a game. And that's very important to keep in mind. Oh, nice whiff punish. In a way, Gecko is kind of a hit-and-run character just by virtue of his really fast walk speed and annoying air movement. Yeah, and I think in situations like this, he also has a threat of just like jumping out of there and doing Tatsu to cross the other side of the screen. Oh. Yeah, there's jump LK out of the reset. When you hit out of a reset, even in the corner, you'll get your diagonal jump normals. I think that's important to remember against Gecko, because his diagonal MK is really good, to be honest. you ever want to look up what that looks like on the wiki, it's just super disjointed. Ooh. Unfortunately, it's mostly horizontal, so if you're right under him like that, you will be able to beat it. I think, honestly, the best thing he can do when he's in the corner, if he's hit high enough, he can dive kick out. And that's an interesting option, because his dive kick is slow, so it's not much of a mix-up, but it's really good for movement. Both the stalling and the fact that he moves really fast once he goes. It is kind of a last-ditch option, but it's there, and, you know, by the time you remember about it, he's probably already out of the corner. Alright, lots of fading back with these double jumps. Oh, nice. Creating a scramble with TK Tatsu, I like it. Alright. Yeah, in that situation, I think using Tatsu would have been wise to just get out of the situation. Oh, no. Yeah, gets chipped out. Good call for maxed out. So, here we are. 2-2 in Losers Finals. Whoever wins this game is moving on to Grand Finals to play Moo Master. Alright, wall dive, that is pretty risky. Nice jump LP to avoid getting knocked down on that reset. Yeah, I think for Gekko, getting in a range where you can either press 2 MP or 2 HP and she'll have to block it, or you can walk forward 6 HK to potentially beat Sucker Crusher or Monkey Call is really good. And the reward on 6 HK is pretty good too. Alternative to Liu Shi, you know, backs up and you whiff it, then you're not in a bad spot. Because it recovers. It actually doesn't have any recovery. It has like 16 startup and some active frames, but he can actually block as soon as he lands. Oh, good sweep. But yeah, using Gekko 6 HK as a movement option is actually kind of good. It doesn't move him forward too much, but you can often, you know, catch an outstretch poke with it. And it will combo into 2 HP. Yeah, nice neutral jump. That's usually your go-to for beating Psycho Crusher. And that way if she like does something else, you can typically react and double jump out. Alright, he's approaching. Nice throw. Oh. Yeah, this is kind of stressful for OG Cornflakes, but if he can land one solid... Aw, man. Gets thrown. Alright, there's still one more round. This is really down to the wire. But he does have Crush. It'll be hard for him to hold on to it. Just because, again, any special you land will spend it. But if you can play a really solid neutral game, you can potentially, you know, when things get really close, alright, not bad to spend it on, you know, you don't really choose to spend it, it's your next special, so it's not bad for it to come out for fireballs. I think you just don't want it to be on Tatsu, because Tatsu does so many hits, and it'll only power up the first hit. But the real kind of gold prize for Gekko is getting desperation damage, or damage on his desperation move from Crush. Alright, yeah. OG Cornflakes has such a big lead, it's really, he can just, yeah, like throw projectiles, kind of jump around, use Tatsu to escape the corner, which any moment now. Or just block it out, yeah, this is it. Alright, GG's. Really close set, but that's going to go to OG Cornflakes 3-2. Alright, Grand Finals. This is it. This is going to be OG Cornflakes coming from losers to face Moo Master. But GG is too maxed out taking third place. Once again, thanks everyone for coming out. If you're interested in picking this game up, definitely check out the wiki or join the Discord. I feel like this is just, you know, it's one of many like Street Fighter 2 clones. It really does a lot of original things that, and I mean, it was unreleased, so obviously it's gonna fly under the radar. It did get a re-release, or an official release, with the Egret 2 mini, which is really interesting. I don't think a lot of unreleased fighting games have really gotten a proper release like that. But being confined to a mini console doesn't really help. Alright, Movemaster picking Marco is really interesting. Marco's got that mash move, that monster mash, which is super rewarding on air hit specifically, where it juggles. On grounded hit, it just kind of pushes them away and doesn't knock down. Oh, yeah. Unfortunate thing is, you can beat that move. It has some invincibility on the start, but that only lasts for a handful of frames. In the later hitbox, he can actually just be hit on his head, so that's what happened there. Yeah, Marco is, you know, comically slow. He kind of looks like the Dalsim archetype at first glance. He does have Rocket Punch, though. He does instant Rocket Punch, that's an overhead, which is frame, like, I want to say 14 after jump, so you're not reacting to that. Only problem is it works at a specific range, and you can, like, you can also just poke the hitbox that he, or the hurtbox that he has on his arm. Alright, well played from OG Cornflakes that round. He didn't really have to eat too many mix-ups from Marco. Because once he gets started, you can kind of eat repeated, like, high-low from him. Switching over to Gonzalez. Kind of a bold pick, in my opinion. Gonzalez does have some godlike air-to-air buttons, though, in that jumping light punch and jumping heavy punch, too. Oh, yeah, the throw. The problem... You have to change your mindset when playing Gonzalez in this compared to most grapplers, because tick throws are kind of non-existent. You have 20 whole frames of throw protection on wake-up or after blocking, so... For the most part, you're looking to like get into a range where you can mix up between command grab, roll, you know, standing heavy kick. He has a kick command grab, so you can option select either the roll, which is all three kicks, or standing heavy kick anti-air. Oh, that was a weird cross-up. Alright. This is weird, because Gonzalez, I mean, he loved to like hit Gekko with a jumping button and, you know, kill him or get back the lead and save his crush for next round. Gonzalez, thankfully, he has like the most stable use of crush because all his special moves are command grabs except for the roll, which doesn't do any damage, so it doesn't get crush. Oh my god, the sweep catching the back dash is just priceless. Alright, nice. Yeah, this... Oh, good jump over the shuriken. That's the thing about throwing that out as a trap, is if they happen to jump at, like, less than an ideal angle, they'll just end up hitting you and using the jump cancel to just go clean over that. Nice. I like the forward heavy kick in the back dash. That's really the best option you have there. I guess you could, like... Tatsu and, you know, take a bit of chip damage, but there's a chance he put yourself in a space where he can punish you for the Tatsu on block. Yeah, I think he might have been able to command grab him there and that would have been it. Alright, 20 seconds left. 20 fast seconds, though, and... Oh! Yeah, nice jump heavy punch to snipe him. It Gekko's outstretched arm on that projectile. But yeah, OG Cornflake's known for sticking to his guns, so... Oh, nice, yeah, there's that mix-up. Again, it doesn't do too much damage. The benefit, I mean, besides usually kind of sneaking you by reversals and, you know, not being punishable on block, is you also get a lot of space off that Oh man, that could have been stun. Gonzalez is a beefy boy, he's hard to stun, but it's still possible for Gekko to stun him with the right route. It relies on a lot of heavy normals, and those can be harder to time in loops, just because of the extra startup. Oh, yeah, that's kind of scary. Now, the interesting thing about trying to buffer command grab out of a roll is it's better for Gonzalez to go for his kick command grab, which is because it can actually negative edge. The input is forward TK. Nice anti-air. So 6-2-6-9K. And because it ends on up, he's allowed to negative edge it. That's the rule with this game for whatever reason. I'm assuming it's to make it easier to do out of jumps. Oh, man, yeah, that 5MK is just such a good anti-air. It hits behind Gekko as well. Yep, just using the double jump, it's really hard for Gonzalez to catch him. Oh, nice, yeah. Using JMK to be the dive kick. Gonz has a pretty good dive kick, but still. Oh, this, I don't think this is gonna kill, but it might come really close. Oh god. Alright, that ties things up. Alright, good double jumps. Think I'm gonna jump back. Yeah, there we go. Creating that kind of like inverted triangle movement, or I guess box movement is more appropriate. Just using, you know, jump back, jump forward Tatsu to get over the corner. I think there's really nothing characters can do about that unless they stop you from jumping in the first place. But yeah, typical Liza stuff in this matchup. What's the score right now? The score is 2-1. OG Cornflakes. There we go. Oh, okay. Gets a knockdown, that's good. Ooh. To be honest, I was expecting OG Cornflakes to just walk up desperation. Sub the final lemon. Liza's not a puppet character, she just kinda uses animal buddies as projectiles. They're kind of like Hilo Tiger, but they're charge. They're really advantageous though. That's like really helpful for her. I will say though, a lot of the characters in this game have really interesting designs. I think Gekko having like so much air mobility is really cool. I think Jay McCoy like having a slide as a charge character is neat. And I think Marco is really like no other character. He doesn't play like Dalsim at all, despite like having the stretchy normals. Oh nice, yeah, there's that jump MK. Right. That was a really good round for OG Cornflakes. If we can do one more of those, this is going to be the reset. Nice. Okay, yeah. On the jump back there, you don't get the Tatsu. I mean, you would have to double jump cancel, and that's possible, but kind of tricky. You might drop it. Okay, this should be dead. No? Alright. This might be Moose's chance for a comeback. Yeah, I think if I'm OG Cornflakes, I'm going to walk forward and look for an anti-air. Oh, that could have been it right there. Oh, okay, tricky wall dives. Oh, yeah. Shuriken going to take that, and that's the bracket reset for OG Cornflakes. Let me update that. Alright, so this is going to be the real Grand Finals reset here for OG Cornflakes. And man, this lobby is really active for like South and Central America right now. Definitely people should keep at it. I know it's kind of hard, there's not a lot of players on, but I will definitely try to do my part and be online. And I like to see people like hosting their own tournaments in South America. I have no problem involving people in mine, like having the split North America and South America, or having them together, but if people do have issues with the connections, that's always an option. Oh, nice. Good catching the dive kick. Yeah, it having that much recovery is why I say it's kind of bad. I think it would have been neat if Liza was able to either control the angle of it, or maybe just act out of the flip with a regular attack. Oh, just getting thrown. Alright. Ooh. Big wall dive.
Round three. Fight.
Oh. Oh, that's gonna stun, alright. This is it. Oh. I don't know. I think Liza mains, like, psychologically, are not capable of doing a stun punish. I'm sorry. Because for her, it's just mash heavy kick. You can even jump before doing it just to make sure you don't miss. Yeah, that's one of the very funny things about her that kind of contributes to her S-tier status. Just because her robbery potential is so high. And, you know, the unfortunate fact is a handful of characters cannot punish that spin kick on block. I think Gecko can't even do anything about it unless he has desperation. Oh, alright. I think in that scenario, Gecko just wants the Tatsu out of there. He'll automatically go backwards. Oh, the empty jump throw, nice. Thing. Oh, nice cross up. Oh man, that jump heavy punch. Again, every time I see a Gecko land an air button like that, I think he's gonna cancel into Tatsu and he's gonna loop them to death. Just the potential for this character to do that is what makes him so good in my eyes. He's just a little hard to play. Right, nice, just doing the single neutral jump. I think that's good. I think Moomaster's been catching on to his double jumps a bit. And yeah, using the bird, like, from the right distance is really good at sniping that. Yep, repeated wall dives, interesting. Oh, that could have been huge, alright. Oh, dang. Yeah, I think OG Cornflakes was trying to slow things down and find an opportunity to start a big combo there, but it just wasn't happening. Alright, the current outlook, I think Moomaster is going to take this, but again, OG Cornflakes has all the tools in order to make this happen. Oh, nice. Aw, man. That would have been a really nice pickup. Remember, the rule in this game is, if you hit someone with two, like, reset buttons in a row, like, two buttons that don't knock down, then they'll get knocked down. But if you hit them with a regular button and then a special move that juggles, they won't get knocked down. So you'll be able to do, like, you know, jump MK Tatsu, jump MK Tatsu repeatedly. So in that situation, you could have done Tatsu, land, jump MK Tatsu, and started the loop. Oh no, that's it. Man, that is just something that can happen with this character. Good games. That was a really close first set, but this Grand Finals reset was dominant for Moo Master. That was fun. I'm so glad, you know. I've been kind of struggling with how to feel about these tournaments because people kind of, not as many people have been coming out, but this was really fun to commentate. Yeah, OG Cornflakes, I can tell. It's definitely a lot to, like, deal with, especially coming back to the game after a while. Like, I feel the same way when I've played the game, like, the last few days. I think we all need to play this game a lot more and really, really level things up. But, yeah, there were a lot of really good plays, especially in that first set. So I think go back and, you know, see what worked for you. All right. So with that, our final results, top three, Moo Master, OG Cornflakes, maxed out. Thanks for playing, everyone. And I will see you guys soon. I mean, next is Cyberbots on Monday. I'm running 2 weeks in a row because I missed the 11th because I was coming back from UMass and kind of recovering from that because I had a scare there where I thought I was going to be stranded in Montreal because there was an impending railway worker strike that thankfully got delayed until, I think, 8 p.m. on that Monday. It was supposed to be at midnight, and I wouldn't have made the train back. But other than that, Monday Cyberbots, Thursday Fight Kid Casuals, and Saturday another Dankuga Lobby Night, which will always be able to go over some stuff. Right, I'm going to see who I can raid right now. Oh, 956 Productions is streaming some Fight of Animals, I guess pre-Vortex Gallery stuff, or stuff from past Vortex Galleries to prepare for this year's Evo. So have fun with that. And don't forget to check out my stream tomorrow. I'm going to have that podcast I was talking about. I'm going to throw that up here. So there's a time if you guys want to tune in tomorrow. It's going to be around the time this stream started, or about an hour earlier from now. We'll see.